transversal, a line that intersects two or more lines. See, a line that intersects two or more lines at distinct point is called transversal. A line that intersects two or more lines at distinct point is called transversal. See now, here these are the two lines. These are the two lines. Now, intersect. Which line? See? A line. See this. This is a line. A line that intersect two or more lines. A line. This is line L. Yes? This is line L. A line that intersect. See, this line intersect two or more lines. This I have shown here two lines. Two or more lines. See, this is line M and this is line N. Okay? A line that intersect two or more lines at distinct point is called transversal. See, distinct point. See, at two points. Yes? Intersect at two points. So this is called the transversal. A line, see, line L intersect two lines at distinct points is called transversal. Is called transversal. Okay. See now this line L, it has intersect for line M and N at two distinct point. Yes? So this line is called the transversal. So this line is called the transversal. Stack. Let's see now transversal. What is mean by transversal? See, a line that, see, what is mean by transversal? See, here I will draw two lines. Line M, N. This is N. Now see, a line, that intersects. A line, see, line L. Line L. What is mean by transversal? See, line L. Line L that intersect two or more lines. See, a line that intersect two or more lines at a distinct points. See now here. Two points are there. Intersect at a distinct points is called transversal. Means it has formed here. See, two points we got here. So this is the transversal. So L is the transversal. See, L, line L intersect line M and N at two distinct points. Yes? Is called transversal. So L is the transversal. Now we have learned what is the transversal. A line that intersect two or more lines at distinct points is called transversal. See here, it has formed two points with these two lines, and so this line is called the transversal. A line that intersect two or more lines at distinct points is called transversal. Okay, now see, we are going to learn here angles made by transversal. Now see, here line M and N, these are the lines. And which is the transversal? P is the transversal. So angles made by transversal. What we are going to learn now? Angles made by transversal. See now, angles made by transversal, interior angles are made by transversal. Then exterior angles are made by transversal. Pairs of corresponding angles are made by transversal. Then pairs of alternate interior angles. Then pairs of alternate exterior angles and pairs of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. These all the angles made by transversal. Now just see here. See, what is mean by interior angles? What are the interior angles? See now, suppose these are the two lines and this is the transversal. Okay, interior angles. Now interior angle means what? The angles which are inside of these two lines. See properly, the angles which are inside of the these two lines. Yes, which are the inside of these two lines. See, so these angle, these angle, these angle and these angle. These angles are called the interior angles. These are angles are called the interior angles. Understood? So which are the interior angles? See, these angle which are inside of these two lines. See, this is the transversal and these are the two lines. Yes, so the angles which are inside of these two lines, that angles are called interior. Inside the, see, these two, these angles are inside of these two lines. Inside of two lines, so interior angles. Okay, so these are the interior angles. Now in this figure, which are the interior angles? See now, these are the two lines and this is the transversal. Okay, these are the two lines, line N and line N, and P is the transversal. So which are the interior angles? See figure, which are inside of these two lines? Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. These are the interior angles. So which are the interior angles? Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. And angle 6. So these are the interior angles. Okay. Now we are going to learn exterior angles. Which are the exterior angles? Now see, in this figure I will explain you. Now interior angles means which angle? Which are inside of these two lines. Now exterior means which are the outside of these lines. Yes, which are the outside of these two lines. See, these are the interior angles. So which are the exterior angles? See, these angle, these are the exterior angles. These are the exterior angles. Now in this figure, which are the exterior angles? See, angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8. So in this figure, which are the exterior angles? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8. Okay. Now next we are going to learn pairs of corresponding angles. Pairs of corresponding angles. Now see, what is mean by corresponding angles? See, what is mean by corresponding angles? See now, in this figure I will explain you. See, the corresponding angles, pairs, we have to write the pair of corresponding angles. So, see now, if I will take these angle, which angle it is? It is above this line. Yes, this angle is above of this line. Yes, so which pair will come for corresponding angle for this? We have to take above of this line. See, these angle and these angle are called the corresponding angles. Same side of transversal. Understood? See now, the angles made by same side of transversal. But now see, it is above of this line. So we have to take the above of this line also, this angle.
happened.
So these angle and this angle pairs of corresponding angle. So in this figure, which will come corresponding angle? Angle 1 and angle 5. This figure, which are the corresponding angles? Angle 1 and angle 5. See, this is above of this line, angle 1, and above of this line, above N, which is 1. And same side, yeah? And now above N line, line M, which angle it is? Angle 5. So angle 1 and angle 5. Okay, this is one pair. Now see, same way. Now this angle over, now which angle we can take? These angle. Okay, so up. Now which side of transversal? Right side of transversal. These are the angles, left side of transversal. Okay. Now right side of the transversal, these angle it has formed. So these and these angle. These and these angle. See, this is right hand side of the transversal and above of this line. So these also we have to take above of this line. Right hand side angle. Okay, see, above of this line it is, this angle is above of this line and right side of transversal. So same way we have to take right side of the transversal above of this line. Okay, so this angle and this angle. So from this which angle it will come? See, these are the two lines and this is the transversal. So right hand side angle above of this line, angle 2. And angle 6. So which angle will come? Angle 2 and angle 6. Okay. Angle 2 and angle 6. So these angles are called corresponding angles. These I am talking about pair of corresponding angles. So now see, which is the corresponding angle now here? Below of this line. Yes, these angles. Yes, below of this line, this angle. So, and same side of transversal, we have to take it. Left hand side, below the lines. See. So, these angle and these angles are called corresponding angles. So, which angle will come in this? Angle 3 and angle 7. See, angle 3 and angle 7. See, these both the angles are down of these two lines, means below these two lines. Yes, and same side, means left side of the transversal. Yes, left side of the transversal. So, angle 3 and angle 7. These are the corresponding angles. Okay, now which, see, these angles. Right hand side of the transversal. Okay, right of the transversal. See, these angles are corresponding angles. Yes, these corresponding angles. So in this figure, which are the corresponding angles? See, right side below the lines 4 and 8. So angle 4. Angle A. So these are the pair of corresponding angles. So these are the pairs of corresponding angles. See, angle 1 and angle 5. Again properly pay attention. Angle 1 and angle 5. See, both the angles are above of this line and same side of the transversal. Yes. Now next, angle 2 and angle 6. Above of these two lines, yes, and right of the transversal, right side of the transversal 2 and 6, then angle 3 and angle 7, angle 3 and angle 7, see, below these lines, yes, and left of the transversal, so 3 and 7, and angle 4 and angle 8, right of the transversal, right of the transversal, yes, and below these lines, down of these lines, yes, means below of these lines, so 4 and 8. So these are the pairs of corresponding angles. Now next point what we are going to learn, pairs of alternate interior angles. Pairs of alternate interior angles. See now, pairs of alternate interior angles. Now, what are the interior angles you understood? What are the interior angles which are inside of these lines, that are the interior angles? Now we have to find pair of alternate interior angles. Pair of alternate interior angles. Now this is the interior angle. This is the interior angle. So which is the alternate angle for this angle? See, this is the alternate angle for this angle. Alternate interior angle. Understood? See, these and these. These are the alternate interior angles. So this is one of the pairs. So now in this figure, which will come the alternate interior angle? See, these are the two lines, same like this. Alternate interior. See, this is the interior angle. Angle 3. So which is the alternate interior angle? Angle 3 and angle 6. Alternate interior angle. So angle 3 and angle 6. Angle 3 and angle 6. Now one more pair we can find for alternate interior angle, which that, see, these angle and these angle. We have to take opposite side of this. But interior, we have to take opposite side of this. See, for this what we do? Alternate interior angle, this and opposite of this. See, it can form like this. S. Yes? See. Yes? So these are these alternate interior angles. Now for these also, now these and these are the pair of the alternate interior angles. So now here we took 3 and 6 over. Now which is alternate interior angle? Interior angle is 4. So which is alternate interior angle? 4 and 5. So here what we will write? Angle 4 and angle 5. These are the pairs of alternate interior angles. These are the pairs of alternate interior angles. See, angle 3 and angle 6 alternate. See, they are interior angle 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the interior angles. But here it has asked write the pair of alternate. So which are the alternate? 3 and 6. See, like S. So this angle and this side angle we have to take. Okay. And here 4 and 5. See, like this. Means this side angle and this side angle we have to take. Okay. So 4 and 5. So these are the pairs of alternate interior angles. Now pairs of alternate exterior angles. Now what we have to find? Pairs of alternate exterior angles. Pairs of alternate exterior angles. Now in this, which are the exterior angles? See, these are the outside angles and exterior angles. These and these are the exterior angles. Yes, everyone knows these are the exterior angles. These are the exterior angles. Which are the exterior angles? These angle, and these angle. These are the exterior angles. Now we have to write the pair of alternate exterior angles. Alternate exterior angles. So now, see, this is first exterior angles I will take. Yes? So which is alternate for this? I told you, like S. For interior angles, what we did? Yes, we did. So these and these angles we took. So for exterior center. See, if you will draw here, you will get here yes. You will get here yes. See, so these angle. Yes, so which are the alternate exterior angle? These angle is alternate exterior angle. So in this figure, which are the alternate exterior angles? C1 and A. Simply you start drawing like this is. So 1 and A. Angle 1 and angle A. These are the alternate exterior angles. Now one more way we can find for these. See, this is also exterior angle. Yes? So what we will do? This angle, which is the alternate exterior angle, this angle. So here 2 and what will come? C. Make shape like this. 2C, 2 and angle 7. Angle 2 and angle 7. These are the pairs of alternate exterior angles. These are the pairs of alternate exterior angles. See, once again I will explain you. See, which are the alternate exterior angles? See here. This is the exterior angle. Yes. So alternate. So what we have to do, I told you. Draw like a S. So with this, these angles will come. Alternate exterior angle. Exterior it has asked, na? And with these angles, these angles will come for the alternate exterior angles. Now, next point, pairs of interior angles on the same side of transversal. Pairs of, see here, what we have to find? Pairs of interior angles, see. These are the interior angles. Pair of, it has asked pairs of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Now, these both the angles are same side of the transversal. See, these angle and these angle. What it is asked? See, pairs of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Interior angles, same side of transversal. See, this is the transversal and this left side will take first. Same side of the transversal. These are the interior angles and these are the same side of the transversal. So which angles will come? See, interior angles, see. Interior angle 3 and 5. So which pair will come? Angle 3 and angle 5. These are the same side of the transversal. Now which will come now next? See, this is also interior angles. This is also interior angles. Now these angle and these angle, both are interior. And these both the angles are same side of the transversal. These are the right side of the transversal. Okay. So in this figure 4 and 6, which angles are there? Angle 4 and angle 6. These are the same side of the transversal. See, pairs of interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So angle 3 and angle 5, same side of the transversal, and these are the interior angles. Angle 4 and angle 6, same side of the transversal, and they are the interior angles. Let's learn the transversal of parallel lines. Transversal of parallel lines. Now what is mean by parallel lines? What is mean by parallel lines? Parallel lines means what? They do not meet at anywhere. They do not meet each other. They are going straight. Yes, yes. So this line L and M is parallel. Line L and M is parallel. They do not meet anywhere. They do not meet anywhere. See, this line and this line, we can say parallel lines. No, can meet each other at this point. Yes, so these lines are not called the parallel lines. See, these lines we can say the parallel lines. No, see, if you will extend this line, see, these lines are called parallel lines. See, these lines are called parallel lines. No. Why? Because if you will see, these lines will extend. And these lines will extend. They meet each other at this point. So, these lines are not called the parallel lines. So, what is mean by parallel lines? They do not meet. The lines do not meet anywhere. The lines do not meet anywhere. Yes. So now here, see, if you will see line L and line N, these are the parallel. See, these lines will go straight. See, straight. They do not meet each other. Yes. So this line L and M parallel. And now here it is given T is the transversal. Line L and M parallel to each other and T is the transversal. T is the transversal. Now, see first, if two parallel lines are curved by a transversal, see, it is curved by transversal T, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Each pair of alternate, see, suppose here I will draw two parallel lines, okay, and T is the transversal. Now what it is given, if two parallel lines are curved by a transversal, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Now which are the alternate interior angles? See, these are the interior angles. Yes, now which is the alternate interior angle for these angles? Alternate interior angle. So now what it is given, pairs of alternate interior angles are equal. So these angles is equal to these angles. So in this figure, which angles we can say equal? 3, angle 3 and angle 8. Both are equal. Angle 3 and angle 8 are alternate interior angles. But when they are equal, when these two lines are parallel, these two lines should be the parallel. What it is given, if two parallel lines are curved by a transversal, each pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Now these 3 and 8 equal. With that now, which is the next alternate interior angle? 1 and 6. So angle 1 is equal to angle 6, we can say. Yes, but if two lines are parallel and it curved by a transversal, its alternate interior angles are equal. What it is given? If two parallel lines are curved by a transversal, each pair of 3 and 8, this is one of the pair, alternate interior angles are equal. So these angle is equal to these angle. Yes? Angle 3 is equal to angle 8 and angle 1 is equal to angle 6. Understood? Now what is the next point? If two parallel lines are curved, see, these are the two parallel lines, line L and M, parallel lines, curved by a transversal. It is curved by a transversal T. Curved by a transversal, then each pair of interior angles, see, these are the parallel lines, suppose, and this is the transversal, okay. Then each pair of interior angles, now this is interior angles, this is interior angles, this is interior angles, see, these all the angles are interior angles of the interior angles of this given figure. Okay, these all are the interior angles. Okay, now interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Now which is the same side of transversal. Now this is the left side of transversal. This angle and these angle. Its measurement is supplementary. When two lines are parallel and cut by a transversal, its interior angles of the same side of the transversal. Interior angles of the same sides of transversal are supplementary. Supplementary means its measurement is 180 degree. Means suppose now angle 3 and angle 6, these are the same side of the transversal. See, transversal T, yes, and this is the left hand side of the transversal. So angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree because they are supplementary. This is the property. Yes. So angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree. They are supplementary. So these are, this measurement is 180 degree. Understood? Interior angles of the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Means if you will add the measurement of these angles, angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree. And same side of the transversal, one more we can say, angle 1 plus angle 8. Now these are the right side of the transversal. Right hand side of the transversal, so angle 1 plus angle 8 is equal to 180 degree because they are supplementary. This, we have this property, it is given. If two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, then each pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Let's solve question number 1. From exercise 5.2, state the property that is used in each of the following statements. See now, if A parallel B, means A is parallel to B, A parallel B, then angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Now tell, angle 1 and angle 5, these are the above of these lines. Yes. Above this line is same side. So which angles are these? These are the corresponding angles. So which property will write here? Corresponding angle property. So which property will come? Corresponding angle property. Okay, now next, sir, if angle 4 is equal to angle 6, then A parallel B, means A and B are, then A parallel B, so which property will come here? See, if angle 4 and angle 6, both are shown equal, angle 4 is equal to angle 6, then A parallel B. So with which property it will come? Alternate interior angles property. Yes, alternate interior angles are equal when two lines are parallel. When two lines are parallel and cut by a transversal, its interior, alternate interior angles are equal. And now it has shown angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Then A parallel B. So which property will come here? Alternate interior angles property. Yes, when two lines are parallel, its alternate interior angles are equal. So, alternate interior property. question. If angle 4, see this angle, angle 4 plus angle 5, angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree, then A parallel B. Then A parallel B means A parallel B. Angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. So which property it is? Interior angles, which property will come? See, this angle 4 plus angle 5. Interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. Interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. You have learned this property, interior angles on the same side of transversal. See, angle 4 and angle 5, these are the interior angles and these are the same side of the transversal. So they are the supplementary. So interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary.